Hello friends, in previous videos we have studied about the static relays. In this video we are going to study about the numerical relays. So numerical relays have certain advantages over the static relays. So let us study the introduction and the block diagram of the numerical relay. First of all, let us study the introduction to the numerical protection. So in the modern power systems, which have grown both in size and complexity, they require fast, accurate and reliable protective schemes to protect the major equipments and to maintain the system stability. Now in the previous years, the power system was not as complex as it is today. Now the today's scenario is such that due to the increase in the complexity as well as rating of the various equipments which are connected in the power system, the requirement is for the fast operation of the protective devices which are used to protect the various equipments of the power system. Now if you consider the conventional protective relays, then they are either of the electromechanical type or of the static type. Now electromechanical relays have the moving components, whereas static relays have the stationary components. So the electromechanical relays which were used earlier have certain drawbacks which are mentioned below. First is, they provide higher burden on the instrument transformers. Now the instrument transformers which are used in conjunction with the electromechanical relays, such as current transformer and potential transformer, their outputs is connected to the relay. Now these relays will provide the greater burden on the instrument transformer. This means that the total VA rating of the instrument transformers, that is CT and PT, increases, which also increases the cost of the equipments. They also require the higher operating time. As the electromechanical relay consists of moving system, their operating time is very high. As a result, they do not provide the fast clearing of the fault. Next is contact problems. Now even though the static relays were used which were having the advantages such that compactness, that is the size of the static relay, is very compact as it does not have any movable elements. Then lower burden, the burden which is introduced by the static relays on the CTs and PTs is very less as compared to the electromechanical relays. Less maintenance. As the movable parts are absent in case of static relays, the maintenance requirement of the static relays is very low. Then high speed of operation. Even though these are the advantages of the static relays as compared to the electromechanical relays, they also suffer from some disadvantages such as inflexibility, they are not flexible. Second is inadaptability to the changing system conditions. Third, complexity. Therefore, increasing interest have been shown in the use of online digital computers for the protection. So to go beyond the electromechanical relays as well as static relays, the interest have been shown in the online computer system which can be used for the protection. So the concept of the numerical protection, employing computers which show much promise in providing improved performance, has evolved during the past few weeks. So the numerical protection scheme uses the online computational data for providing the proper protection to the various equipments of the power system. Because of this, the greater interest have been developed in manufacturing of the numerical relays and their use in the power system protection as compared to the static relays and electromagnetic relays. So the conventional relays of the electromechanical and static type had no significant drawbacks in their protection functions. Now the relays which were earlier used, that is electromechanical relays or the static relays, they were operating properly. There was no error in their operation. But with the increasing complexity of the power system, certain additional features are required to be added to the protective relaying scheme. These additional features can be obtained from use of numerical relays. But the additional features which are offered by the microprocessor technologies have encouraged the evolution of the numerical relays that introduced many changes in the power industry. Now, the numerical relays basically use the microprocessor. Microprocessor is acting as the brain of the total equipment, that is a relaying unit. Now, the programming is done on the microprocessor. Depending upon what are the parameters that are fed in the program, the microprocessor operates. The economics and the additional functionality were the main factors that forced the power industry to accept the cope with the changes brought about by the microprocessor or microcontroller based numerical relays. Now, the main part of the numerical protection are the numerical relays. So, let us study about the numerical relays. So, the numerical relay is the latest development in the area of the power system, and it differs from the conventional relays both in design and methods of operation. It has been developed because of the tremendous advancement of the VLSI and the computer technology. So, basically, numerical relay is based on the digital devices such as microprocessor. So, the programming is done in the microprocessor. Complete control of the relay operation is based on the programming of the microprocessor. Second is microcontroller. Next is digital signal processors. So, basically, the input which is required to the microcontroller is of the digital type. But the output which we get from the CTs and PTs is of the analog type. So, the processing of the signals needs to be done. That is done by using the digital signal processors. So, this relay acquires the sequential samples of the AC quantities in the numerical data through the data acquisition system, that is DAS. Then, whatever data is acquired by the data acquisition system is processed numerically using relaying algorithm to calculate the fault discriminations and make the decisions. In the numerical relay, the analog current and voltage signals are monitored through the primary transducers and are conditioned, sampled at a specified time and converted into digital form. Now, the transducer which are used are the current transformers and the potential transformers. The output of the current transformer and the potential transformer is in the analog form. But as I have already explained, the input to the microprocessor should be in the digital form. So, whatever output is obtained from the CT and PT needs to be converted into digital form. So, for this, analog to digital converter is used. Now, the output of the analog to digital converter will be the digital value. Now, there might be certain disturbances in the signal, so it needs to be processed. So, the signal which is converted in the digital form due to first numerical manipulation, second analysis, third display, fourth recording. Now, this process will provide a flexible and very reliable function, thereby enabling the same basic hardware units to be used for almost any kind of relaying scheme. Now, this is one of the most important advantage of the numerical relay. One numerical relay can be used for the number of relaying schemes. In case of electromechanical relay, for a particular relaying scheme, a single electromechanical relay is used. For example, if you want to protect the system or the equipment from the overcurrent protection, then we have to use the overcurrent relay. If we want to protect the system from the earth fault, then the separate earth fault relay should be used. But in case of numerical relay, all these protection schemes can be provided by the single relay. Thus, a numerical relay has an additional entity called as software, which runs in the background and makes the relay functional. So, whatever decisions are taken by the relay are depending on the software. Software runs in the background of the numerical relay and it takes the suitable decisions. The hardware is more or less same in the numerical relays. The software used in the numerical relay depends upon processor used and the type of relay. Hence, with the advent of numerical relay, depends upon processor used and the types of relays. So, the evolution of the modern numerical relay has thus taken place from torque balancing device to a programmable information processor. So, initially the numerical relay that was developed was only for the torque balancing, but from there it has developed to the programmable information processor. So, the basic block diagram of the typical numerical relay is as shown in figure. So, this is our power system. Then here we have the transducers. Now, the transducers are the instrument transformers, that is CT and the PT. The output of CT and PT is in the analog form. This output is given to the analog input isolation. Then it goes to the I2V converter. Now, I2V converter is used for converting the value of current into the voltage. Then it goes to the low pass filter. In case of low pass filter, certain impurities in the signal or the harmonics will be filtered out. Then there is one sampling and hold circuit. Then we have the analog multiplexer. So, multiplexer takes one input and give multiple outputs. After this, we have A to D converter, that is analog to digital converter. So, the analog quantity will be converted into digital quantity. Then the output of this is given to the microprocessor or microcontroller. So, the block diagram of the typical numerical relay is as shown in figure. This relay samples voltage and current, which are at the power system level, are in the range of hundreds of kilovolts to kiloamperes respectively. Now, whatever current and voltage we receive at the output of the CT and the PT can be of the range of hundreds of kilovolts and kiloamperes. This value of voltage and current is sampled by using the sample voltages. So, the level of these signals are reduced by the voltage and current transformers. The output of the transformers is given to the signal conditioner. So, the signal conditioner is one of the important component of the data acquisition system, that is DAS. It brings the real world signal into digitizer. So, the signal which is received from the CT and PT, it is fed to the signal conditioner. So, signal conditioner will give it to the signal digitizer. From the figure, the signal conditioner performs the following function. First is, it will electrically isolate relay from the power system. Second is, it will reduce the level of the input voltages. Whatever voltage is received from the output of the potential transformer, that level is reduced as per the required value by using the signal conditioner. Next is, it will convert the current into equivalent voltage. Now here, the quantity that is fed to the microprocessor should be of one quantity. That is, we cannot feed one voltage and one current. There will be no comparison. As a result, whatever current is obtained at the output of the current transformer needs to be converted into equivalent voltage. It will remove high frequency component from the signal using the analog filters. This we have already seen. The relay is isolated from the power system by using auxiliary transformer, which receives analog signal and reduce the level to make them suitable for use in the relay. So, whatever output we are receiving from the CT and PT has to be reduced to the level which is required for the operation of the relay. Since analog to digital converters accept the voltage signal only, the current signals are converted into proportional voltage signals by using I2V converter, that is current to voltage converter, or by passing it through the precision shunt resistor. The analog to digital converter, which is used to convert the analog signal into the digital signal, it only requires voltage at the input. So, whatever current is received from the output of the current transformer needs to be converted into equivalent voltage. So, to convert this current into equivalent voltage, current to voltage converter is used or a shunt resistor is used. Now we know that by the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So the value of current can be given by I is equal to V by R. Now if you want to convert the current into equivalent voltage, then we have to multiply it by resistance R. So if we multiply both sides of equation by R, we get IR is equal to V. Hence, by introducing the shunt resistor, the current can be converted into equivalent voltage. There are also anti-aliasing filters, which are low-pass filters and are used to prevent the aliasing affecting various functions. Now, the output of the signal conditioner is applied to the analog interface, which has the following circuits. First is sample and hold circuit, that is S by H. Second, analog multiplexer. Third is analog to digital converter. Now these components, that is sample and hold circuit, analog multiplexer and analog to digital converter, will reduce the level signal and convert their analog levels to the equivalent number that is stored. So the status of the isolator and the circuit breaker in the power system is provided to the relay via digital input subsystem and are read into the microcontroller or microprocessor memory. Now after quantization by the A to D converter, analog electrical signals are represented by the discrete values of the samples taken at the specified instant of the time. So the sampling is done of the output of the CT and PT. Now the signal is in the form of discrete numbers and it is processed by a relaying algorithm by using the numerical methods. So whatever signal is obtained, it is converted into discrete numerical signal. Now a relaying algorithm which possesses the acquired information is the part of the software. So the information is already fed into the software. So software will convert this value with the value of the numerical signal that is obtained from the power system. So the algorithm will use signal processing technique to estimate the real and imaginary components of the fundamental frequency, voltage and current phasors. Now in some of the cases, the frequency of the system can also be measured. So basically, only voltage and current is taken, but there are certain systems which also take the frequency. Now these measurements which are obtained are used to calculate the other quantities such as impedance. So the computed quantities are compared with the pre-specified threshold to decide whether the power system is experiencing the fault or not. So the threshold value is already fed to the microprocessor. Whatever computed quantities are obtained by following all the processes, this value is compared with the threshold value. If the value is equal to the threshold value, then it will say that the fault is present. Otherwise, the fault is absent. Now, if there is a fault in the power system, the relay sends the trip command to the circuit breaker for the isolation of the faulty zone of the power system through the digital output subsystem. So if it is detected that there is a faulty condition, then the trip command will be sent to the circuit breaker by the use of digital output subsystem. Now let us study what are the advantages of the numerical relays. So the first advantage is compactness. So the numerical relays are compact in size and reliable in operation. Next advantage is flexibility. Numerical relays offer flexibility because of programmability. Some general purpose hardware can be used to perform a variety of protection functions with the change of stored program only. So if we go on changing the program or the values of the input quantities that are given to the programming, we can obtain the number of protection schemes. So the drastic addition or alteration of the protection logic. So the drastic addition or alteration of the protected logic hardly require any change of the hardware. Next is adaptive capability. So the numerical relays can adapt themselves to the changing system conditions by monitoring the operating quantities from the digital inputs of the relay. As a result, the behavior of the processor can be made to change automatically depending on the external conditions, which might change with time. So whatever initial conditions are fed to the microprocessor, they can be made to change with the ongoing external conditions. These conditions keep changing with respect to time. So the basis of this change can be either local information available to the processor or an extra source such as data link or the central computer system. So depending upon the information that is gathered, the decision has to be taken. Next is multiple functions. So the numerical relays can provide many functions that were not previously available in the electromechanical or the static designs. These functions include, first is multiple setting groups, next programmable logic, third adaptive logic, fourth it is self-monitoring, fifth self-testing, sequence of event recording, oscillography, ability to connect with other relays, control computers. So these were the various features which were absent in the electromechanical and the static relays, but they are introduced in the numerical relays. Now while these features make the relay very powerful, they also introduce factors such as complexity, which were earlier absent. So with the increase in the features, the complexity of the numerical relay also increases. Next advantage is detailed logic and mathematical capabilities. So the programmer in the numerical relays is free to provide almost any characteristic within the limit of its understanding. Specific protection problems can be broken down into fine details and handled separately. So this can be done by using the proper logic. Now in addition to this, the measurement problem can be stated as a mathematical equation and it can be directly implemented. Next advantage is economic benefits. Now the cost per function of the numerical relays is lower as compared to their economical and static counterparts. Now one numerical relay can perform multiple functions. Hence the cost for per operation is very less if we compare the numerical relay with their electromechanical relays. Next is self-monitoring and self-testing. So the relay can perform the function of the self-monitoring and testing. These features will reduce the need for routine maintenance. As the self-monitoring and self-testing is done by the numerical relays, it does not require the frequent maintenance schedule. Next advantage is low burden on the instrument transformers. So the numerical relays impose significantly less burden on the CTs and PTs. As a result, low rating of CT and PT can be used, which will reduce the overall cost. Now let us study what are the disadvantages of the numerical relays. First disadvantage is short life cycle. Second is susceptibility to the transients. Third is setting and testing capabilities. So in this way, we have studied the introduction to the numerical relays. We have also studied its block diagram and studied the advantages and disadvantages associated with the numerical relays. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.